Hi, welcome to Elonics. In this episode, we'll make an adjustable delay timer circuit using a 555 timer IC. The timer is activated by pressing the push button switch and the output turns on immediately. It stays on and turns off only after the specified time has elapsed. Here I've configured the timer to turn off after approximately 30 seconds. You can also adjust the timer to any fixed duration like 1, 5, 10 minutes, etc. by changing the value of this resistor or capacitor. We'll discuss more about that later in this video. 30 seconds are almost getting elapsed, and so the output should turn off in 3, 2, 1, and this is it. Dynamic adjustment of the delay time is also possible by using a potentiometer. So we can adjust the timer duration on the fly. Right now the output automatically turns off after the specified delay, but we can also make the output to turn on after the delay by connecting it between the output and positive rail. Here I've used a red LED to indicate that the timer has completed the required duration. And for controlling heavy loads or AC appliances, etc., the circuit can be clubbed with a relay module. We'll also learn how this circuit works later in this video, so stay tuned. For the list of components required, link to the circuit diagram, or any other information, please go through the description below. We'll be using this row as positive rail and this as negative rail. Place 555 timer IC on the breadboard with its notch facing up, and these are the pin numbers with respect to the notch. Now connect pin 1 to negative rail and pin 8 to positive rail. Next connect pins 4 and 8 of the 555 timer IC to each other, and similarly connect the pins 6 and 7 to each other. Next connect a 33 kilo ohm resistor between pin 6 and positive rail. Extend the negative rail and place a 470 microfarad capacitor with its positive terminal connected to pin 6 of the 555 timer IC and negative terminal connected to the extended negative rail. You can refer to this table on what values of resistor or capacitor you need to use for any given delay duration. For this circuit, we have used a resistor of 33 kilo ohms and capacitor of 470 microfarad, so the delay should be around 15 seconds. Next, take a momentary push button switch. It has 4 pins, of which 2 pins are internally connected to each other and the other 2 to each other. We need to place the interconnected pins in a vertical direction. Now connect pin 2 of the 555 timer IC to the push button switch and connect the other interconnected pin to positive rail via a 10k resistor. Connect the other interconnected pair to negative rail. So normally pin 2 has a positive voltage applied on it by default, and when the push button is pressed, 0 volts is applied on it. Now extend pin 3 of the 555 timer IC, connect anode of the LED to this extended row, and cathode to the negative rail via a 220 ohm resistor. And please refer to this table for the exact value of LED series resistor to use. Finally, turn on the power supply and activate this automatic delay timer circuit. In this case, it should turn off after approximately 15 seconds, and it depends on the value of this resistor and capacitor you use. We can also replace the timing resistor with a potentiometer in order to dynamically control the delay duration. For turning on the output after the delay time has elapsed, we need to connect the negative terminal of the output to the output pin of 555 timer IC and the positive terminal to positive rail. And since pin 4 is already connected to positive rail via pin 8, I've connected this LED's other terminal to pin 4 via the series resistor. A relay module can also be connected for controlling AC appliances or heavy loads. This module has an inbuilt transistor that inverts the input. So whenever the 555 timer's output is off, the relay module will turn on the output and vice versa. You can also change this default behavior by connecting the output to normally connected pin of the relay. Let's now try to understand how this circuit works. In the previous tutorials of 555 timer project series, we have learned how the trigger pin, pin 2, and the threshold pin, pin 6 of the 555 timer IC sense voltages and control the output. And this is a quick recap. If the trigger pin, pin 2 of the 555 timer IC senses any voltage less than 1/3 of the supply voltage, it turns on the output. If the threshold pin, pin 6 of the 555 timer IC senses any voltage more than 2/3 of the supply voltage, it turns off the output. And whenever the output of the 555 timer IC is in off state, the discharge pin, pin 7, acts as a ground or negative rail, which means that it is internally connected to 0 volts. Using these three fundamentals, let's try to understand how this circuit works. Initially, when this circuit is powered on, the output will be in off state. Whenever the output is in off state, the discharge pin, pin 7, will be internally connected to 0 volts. So the capacitor completely discharges and won't be able to charge via the series resistor that connects it to positive rail. After the momentary push button switch is pressed, which means that the delay timer is activated, the following sequence happens. 0 volts is applied at the trigger pin, pin 2, via the push button switch. And since this applied voltage, which is 0 volts at pin 2, is less than 1/3 of the supply voltage, the output turns on. Simultaneously, the discharge pin disconnects internally from 0 volts. So now the capacitor starts charging via the resistor or potentiometer that connects it to positive rail. Since the threshold input pin is connected to positive terminal of the capacitor, it actively monitors the voltage across it. And as soon as the capacitor charges to 2/3 of the supply voltage, pin 6 turns off the output. This time period for which the capacitor charges from 0 volts to 2/3 of the supply voltage is the delay time. As soon as the output turns off, pin 7 is internally reconnected to 0 volts and the capacitor is discharged completely. And these steps are repeated each time the push button switch is pressed. Here you can practically observe the charging and discharging of the capacitor. Immediately after the push button is pressed, the capacitor gradually charges, and once the voltage across it reaches 2/3 of the supply voltage, it discharges to 0 volts. And if we use a smaller resistance, the capacitor charges quickly and so the delay time will be less. You can find more details on this in the description. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe and have fun.